This video will provide instruction on the preparation of Hubble's 350 and 570G series isolated ground and all dielectric closures, cable installation into the closures, and sealing the closures. The process for the isolated ground closure and the all dielectric closure is the same except for the installation of the cable shield connectors and isolated ground connections. We will be using the Hubble 350 isolated ground small dome closure for this training video, as the steps for the installation are very similar for the 350 and 570G. The following tools are required in addition to those used in normal splicing practices: ratchet socket or box open end wrench 7/16, ratchet socket or box open end wrench 3/8 inch, flat blade screwdriver, hex key wrench 1/8 inch. Turn collar knobs counterclockwise to the unlock position and remove the collars. Loosen the compression bolts on the end plate to allow the compression seal to be relaxed. Remove the dome housing and set it aside. The closure comes fully assembled to reduce labor cost for assembly time, avoid lost or missing parts, avoid craft error, and minimize loose parts in the box. Remove the compression bolt around the cable entry ports to be used. Remove the freed section of the split compression seal and set aside. Prepare the cable per standard local practice. Refer to the installation guide for the recommended buffer tube and exposed fiber lengths. Install shield bond connector for shielded cable in accordance with standard practice. This step is not applicable for all dielectric cable. Install termination standoff bracket and secure central strength member. Measure the cable and select the correct grommet for the cable size. Additional information is provided in the closure assembly instruction manual included with the closure. Cut the grommet and spread it open to apply a bead of RTV inside the grommet. If using the peel-out grommet, use the included measuring tape to determine how many peel-outs need to be removed for the cable. Spread out the peel-out grommet and replace a bead of RTV inside the grommet. Remove the seal assembly from the platform for additional room. When performing a mid-sheath splice, the platform may be disconnected from the end plate to make the cable installation into the prepared cable ports much simpler. Place a bead of silicone along the inside seal of the elastomer. Insert the grommet into the elastomer and tighten down the standoff nut to the inside plate assembly. Place a bead of silicone along the inside of the removed section of the elastomer. Reinstall the piece of elastomer removed earlier and loosely install the removed bolts. Remove the other unused portion of the elastomer and place a bead of RTV along the inside cut, and then install the solid plugs into the grommet holes. Reconnect the platform and cable seal assembly after installing the cable butt ends into the seal. For isolated ground closures, connect the number 6 cable to the shield bond connectors installed on the cable. Route excess buffer tube storage under the splice trays and install the splice trays into the platform. Remove the outside of the watertight connector and pull through the ground rod. Loosen the set screw to prepare and insert the number 6 grounding cable from the OSP system. Once installed, tighten the set screw and reinstall the covers for their watertight seal. Install the platform and seal assembly back in the dome of the enclosure. Retighten the bolts on the outside of the closure per the included instruction manual. Install the collar onto the base of the closure housing. Turn collar knob clockwise into the over-center lock position. an air valve is provided for flash testing. The collar must be installed prior to flash testing. Only pressurized to 4 to 6 PSI. Relief pressure after proper seal is verified.